I would think that the happiest person in the whole world might be a naive fool, you know, that wouldn't know to be concerned or be vigilant. The hopes and dreams that I have had when I was a child and what I could be in the world and what it would make me feel like, the reality of that was very different. And that's the death of optimism. I can revisit those times now from the safety of being a different person.
Williams. This is my band and this is my ass.
Of such a great show, what are your thoughts?
To not become overwhelmed with what's about to happen in the evening. You know, in the past, I'd wake up anxious and feel as though that I need to have some form of energy that surpasses any energy that I've had before. And to want to feel that way for 12 hours in your waking hours is impossible. Mm-hmm. So I just try to breathe and maintain some sort of calm.
Elvis, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change.
Uh-huh.
Courage to change the things I can.
Uh-huh.
And the wisdom to know the difference.
Thank you very much.
So put your hands across.
The fact that I am a middle-aged pop star and I can still attract that many people to come and see me was something that I'd been thinking about weeks, if not months before.
Mm.
The fact that there's 100,000 people there made me feel really, really good. And also, after COVID, I have a different perspective on my life and my job. I get to embrace it more than I've embraced it before. Really? And to actually genuinely love my audience and be grateful that they exist.
Was this a terrible time for you, the 2 years of lockdowns, COVID, anxieties? Or did you appreciate the silence?
Listen, I, when I answer this, I understand that the world had a different view on what was happening. I had a great time. I was with my children and I was with my wife. And there was nothing we could do about anything other than be in each other's company. We will probably never be able... God willing, and you know, touch wood, we'll probably never be able to experience that again. So I know that other people had different times, and you know, I'm not belittling their experience. My personal experience was Yeah, I got to be a family man.
I do a lot of interviews and the stars are always like rushing. And you're so relaxed.
I'm interested in people and I'm interested in people being interested in me. It feeds me and it's also very therapeutic, this part of my job. Most people are really good at their job and ask interesting questions, which forces me to think about what I think and feel about the important matters of the world and my life. Mm-hmm. This doesn't eat my energy. This gives me energy.
Great. And I like very much your style. It's very uplifting.
Well, I've been wearing black every day for the last 5 days. And my daughter pointed out to me, Daddy, why is your wardrobe just black? And I didn't want to say to her, well, most of the time Daddy's overweight and he needs to look thin. That's why it's black. And today, I just thought, I'll go the opposite of what I've been doing and throw some colours at my day to see how I feel.
But you're looking thin, also
in
colours.
I am right now. I'm in that moment. I'm in that moment that I look back on and go, oh, why can't I get back to that?
And I also love your hair. I love the grey.
Thank you.
It suits you very well, also your eyes, and it makes you mature.
Yeah, there is a obsession with youth that we all have, which can cause you to do that dying black thing, which I've also tried. But then you look like that middle-aged guy trying to be a young person with hair that is too dark. Mm. And that's more embarrassing than actually getting old.
Life running through my veins going to waste 1995
to 2001 where I'd lost myself, and I can revisit those times now from the safety of being a different person.
It's the love you lost in yourself.
The trust and the love and the faith in absolutely everything. The planets, its works, my parents, my friends, me, my job. The hopes and dreams that I have had when I was a child and what I could be in the world and what it would make me feel like, the reality of that was very different. And that's the death of optimism. I lost my
You rise like a phoenix.
I did rise like a phoenix, yeah. I mean, you know, like a phoenix that's, you know, whose wings were still a little bit clipped, but nevertheless, I rise.
What's the biggest difference between Rob 25 years ago and this Robbie Williams sitting in front of me?
Rob 25 years ago had a lunatic. If I'm a car and I'm the occupants of the car, the lunatic was at the wheel and he was responding to any emotion with extremities in a negative manner. The lunatic sits in the back of the car now, and a more grown-up person drives the car. The lunatic still exists, but I don't have to react to everything with such extreme measure.
I'm appreciating so much how you speak about your own mental health. What gives you the strength to be so powerful?
The naivety to not know that I shouldn't. You know, I don't understand why you wouldn't, and I don't understand why I can't. And I have a compulsion to... I suppose that back in the day, it's now a joy to talk about it, because when I was granted so much back in the day, my professional career was at the top of the mountain. How can you complain? You know, anything that you say, hey, the mathematics of this situation is this happens and I feel this way. It doesn't feel good. You know, you weren't allowed to say it. Now I can say it with the extreme spotlight moving on to other people. Say, hey, that existed. It made me feel this way and it still exists. And I feel this way. And people don't have the same reaction to it that they used to. You know, there's more empathy.
Yeah.
There's more empathy from people and more understanding. And the sociopaths aren't in charge of the conversation. The sociopaths have had to listen to people and go, well, maybe we should take notice of this and act accordingly. Some things change for the better.
Is it a new quality in your life that you allow yourself being vulnerable?
No, I've always allowed myself to be vulnerable. I haven't necessarily been allowed to be vulnerable. It goes back to what I've just said, you know. Vulnerability is now applauded. This conversation is allowed to happen without judgment. You know, you're allowed to have great things happen to you and still feel unwell mentally. It's not unusual.
I lost my place in life. I lost my point of view. I lost what it is to love. When I lost my faith.
Now on your side is a very beautiful family, a great wife, great kids. How does this change your mindset? I love your smile.
Yeah, well, they make me be the best version of myself that I can be. I always wanted to be a good boy. I always wanted to do the right thing by people. And the right thing to do by my wife is to treat her with the respect that she deserves in every opportunity that I get. In doing so, on a day-to-day basis, I have not behaved in a way that is shameful to me. I've not lied to me and I've not lied to her. In almost every aspect, apart from medicine and pills, I had to lie there. But apart from that, you know, she gives me purpose. And I am fed from her, she is fed from me. And why would you fuck over your best mate? You know, she's really smart, she's really funny, she's really cool to look at. And I trust her and she trusts me. I should honor that trust. I love you more than I did on our wedding day. Because I wasn't sure, frankly.
She's posting very funny clips of your daily life. Are they spontaneous or are you planning this?
Yeah, they're very spontaneous. Whenever she feels as though, you know, we should post something. Okay, boom. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm on a looking for a dollar. This is again awesome. All the essentials. Yeah, just the essentials. Just the essentials. I had an overwhelming need for sugar in that moment. And the children got very, very lucky because of my desire to eat everything that's bad for you that exists in the supermarket. Mm.
So in this moment, you seem like the happiest person in the whole world.
I'm very content, you know. I would think that the happiest person in the whole world might be a naive fool, you know, that wouldn't know to be concerned or be vigilant. I would say I feel better than okay. And that's a miracle considering how I felt.
When I lost my faith in you. Dankeschön!